Oh mein Dennis. Hello, hey everybody. I'm not gonna be on here long. I'm working real quick. I'm doing good. How are you? How are you doing? Hello. Made sure. Thank you. Hello, what's everybody doing? What's going on? Where's everybody from? Drop it down below. Hit the like on the way in, boo. Hit the like on the way in. Hey. Thank you. Oregon, Arizona, Jackson, Mississippi, Chicago. Thank you. Do you like it? This is new. I'm up working. I'm doing really good. Thank you so much. Y'all get in here. I gotta tell y'all something. So, I'm gonna tell you guys my very worst. Thank you. You like it? This is my being. Oh, Bama. Hey, Bama. Thank you for sharing the live, Logan. So, listen, y'all, I have to tell y'all my worst date night story. We need to get to. Hey, King Pretty LaBelle, Petty LaBelle. Hey, boo. That's my girl. Thank you, girl. I have a date night story that I want to tell y'all. Let's get the 10K. Let's get the 10K on the likes. Thank you, boo. And then I'll tell the story. Oh my gosh, Josh. Thank you. Thank you. This is actually a suit, like a set. But my bra is kind of. It's a pants set. It may be a little too sexy for on here, child. This foundation that I'm wearing right now, my foundation, here. It's Estee Lauder. Estee Lauder Double Wear. Yeah, this might be a little bit too much. I don't want to get in trouble, girl. It's a jumpsuit, though. It's like a jumpsuit. Girl, you know they be judging us real hard. And I don't want to get in trouble. So listen, let me tell y'all this story real quick. So, I'm waiting on y'all to get me the 10K likes. I said I was gonna wait till y'all got the 10K for us to do it. Thank you, Josh. Welcome, welcome, welcome. For all of you who don't know me, my name is Joy, and I am a plus size influencer, averaging about 30 to 40 million views per month on YouTube. That is my main platform. I help plus size women fall in love with their wardrobe. Okay, it's my job to help plus size women, specifically plus size women. Listen, I love all women. I love all women, okay? But my job is to be a resource specifically for plus-size women to help them fall in love with their wardrobe. I want them to, hey boo, I want them to wear the clothing that they love. I am a size 28 on a 30. My arms are the largest part of me, and I love to look cute. I go to the gym. I'm on a lifestyle journey with my eating, getting my health, my wellness together. But in the meantime, between time, I'm going to be cute. So, oh my God, thank you, Chandra. Thank you, Letitia. I love you so much, Mary. Y'all know, listen, I ride 10 toes down for the plus size queens, for all of the pretty ass fat girls who like to wear cute clothes and need resources. That is my number one job. I do like to travel. I like to travel. No. I'm sorry, y'all. I got a cough. Hey, Ash. So, it's my number one goal to help. I am an E. Lord have mercy. Girl, this is a brand new wig. I just opened it. It look like it's a year old. You crazy as hell. My wig look good. This is my Beyonce hair. You is crazy as hell. This my Beyonce hair, girl. Stop hating. This is cute. Anyway, so you guys check me out on YouTube, Joy Amore, if you don't already know. If you do know, you know I love you, girl. And again, I'm always looking for ways to help all the fat girls. Whether it's clothes, whether it's travel, whether it's resources, no matter what it is. Listen, I love all my haters, but sometimes y'all just be lying. Now, come on now. But I'm cute. I look very cute. Are you crazy? Okay, I can help you, and I can help your baby. Send them to my channel. I just dropped... Listen, again, I love every woman. There's a lot of women who follow me who are not overweight. But I specifically specialize. My specialty is the plus size queen. If you are on the larger side of plus, meaning 24, 26, 28, 30, I got you, sis. When it comes to whatever you need. Hey, boo. Hey, Kali. Hey, boo. Congratulations on your engagement. No, babe. I don't do loans. No, I don't do loans. No financing. I'm not available for financing. You welcome, Pooh. So anyway, y'all, let me tell y'all about this story. We almost there. We at what, 8K? Hey, Dallas. We almost there, girl. This came from Curls and Curls. I'm actually in the middle of working right now doing a hair video. Thank you. I appreciate you, Mel. So listen, y'all. I was talking to this guy, right, this one time. Thank you so much for the roses. God is courage? So listen, y'all. Y'all better not tell nobody this story I'm about to tell y'all. Hey, Sandra. Thank you for the gifts, boo. Okay, so listen. I was on a fat girl dating site, right? Now, this was back in the day, right? This was probably about 7 years ago. So, I was on the fat girl dating site. And I was talking to this guy. And he was a little chocolate dip or whatever. And I really liked him. He was so fine, y'all. He looked like Diamond. Y'all know Diamond from what's the strip show? P-Valley. Y'all know Diamond from P-Valley? He kind of looked like that, right? And so we was talking, and he worked for the city, right? And he was in Fort Myers. Now, I live in Florida. He lives in Fort Myers. So he told me, so now listen, anybody who knows me knows that back in the day, I always go to dates first thing in the morning because I can be a certified hoochie, right? And I don't want to be a hoochie, right? So I always go to dates first thing in the morning. So that way I have to go to work afterwards and that prevents me from being too intimate too early. Thank you, Jessica. Welcome. Thank you, Scotty. So anyway, we started talking and I really was feeling him or whatever. And he wanted to go to breakfast. So he was like, listen, I'm finna come over there and I'm finna take you to breakfast. And I was like, listen, I don't want to go to breakfast. Let's just go get some coffee. So he came over to me from Fort Myers. Thank you, boo. Welcome. No, I am not, Ashley. Ashley is lying. I am not married. Anyway. So un momento. So anyway, I don't remember his name, y'all. I'm not even gonna lie. Hey, boo. Hey, Belinda. So he brought his ass all the way over here or whatever, right? Now, mind you, we had been talking online, but I had never seen him in person. We had only FaceTime online. We've been online and we had been talking, right? And I really, really liked him because he wasn't overly sexual. He didn't ask me for pictures 10,000 times. None of that. He was, you know, anytime that I called him, he would answer the phone. He always would FaceTime me at night while he was in bed. So I felt really comfortable. I thought he was really cool. Mind you, like I said, he worked for the city. So, okay, you got a job. I got a job. You live a little ways away, but we still should be good. Long story short, girl. So he brought his ass over here from Fort Myers, right? And we went. Hold on. Thank you for sharing the live and thanks for the roses, y'all. So he came over here from Fort Myers, right? Now, anybody who knows me knows that I'm a very transparent person. So I was really, really looking forward to the date just because I was attracted to him. He was nice. He had a good job. He wasn't asking me for pictures every 5 minutes because I can't stand that. To me, it's like we just met online. You see my pictures on a dating site. Why every day you keep asking me for pictures? And we keep talking to each other on FaceTime. Like, it don't make sense. So anyway, he came over, right? We went on the date, or we met, we went to breakfast, then we went to the park, and then we just kept talking, and one thing led to the other, okay? So annoying, right? It's like, why do you keep asking me for pictures? Like, do you not believe who I am, or do you just want to collect pictures in your phone? Like, why do you keep asking me for pictures? Hey, boo. So anyway, so we went to the park, everything was fine. We kissed, everything was fine. And he just, like, I kept telling him, listen, I gotta go. I gotta go, I gotta go, I gotta go. And he was like, no, like, I don't want you to go. Now, mind you, we met for breakfast at like 10:30. Okay, let's just say it was a Saturday, right? Girl, whenever they send me those type of pictures, I send them back a picture of Richard Nixon, okay? When they send me a D-pic, I send them Richard Nixon. Like, and then I block you, right? Because ain't nobody got time for that. And they don't, it don't even be looking all that good. That's the thing. Like, if you're going to send me one that look good. How you going to send me one and it don't even look good? And then you got little, like, pieces of, like, fabric rolled up in the little hairs. Like, ain't nobody got time for that. So, anyway. So, the date, but, you know, he looked even better in person. The only thing that was different was that he was a little bit chubbier. Listen, don't be mad. Don't kill the messenger. Hey, boo. Don't kill the messenger. I'm just being honest, okay? So he was a little bit chunkier than the pictures he had shown me and then how he looked when we was FaceTiming. But that it was completely fine because he was so cute to me, right? So we was vibing and I kept telling him, like, you know, I gotta go. And I didn't really have, like, nowhere to go. But I just was like, I kept having that feeling like, he trying to spend the night. And I'm like, I just met him. Even though we had been talking on the phone for like 3 months at this point, this was our first official meeting in person. And I just was like, mm-mm, you got to go home. You cannot stay here. So we go to the park. We go walking. Like, he takes my car and gets my car clean. Everything is perfect, right? Then he was like, hey, I'm hungry. Let's go eat. Now, mind you, when we went to breakfast, we didn't really eat anything. We just had coffee, right? And we each paid for our own coffee. Right. No spending the night. No spending the night on the first date. So, lo and behold, he was like, oh, I'm hungry. Let's go eat. I'm like, okay. I didn't even think of it. So, we go to eat at this place called Glory Days, right? We go to this place called Glory Days. So we go to Glory Days. Now, Glory Days back then was my joint, my joint, right? So we get to Glory Days, and listen, he ordering all this food. I'm ordering my food. You know, it didn't even cross my mind. So, girl, tell me why the check come. What do you think happened? Thank you, boo. Girl, what do you think happened when the check come? He tells me he didn't have his wallet, that he forgot his wallet. So, I didn't want to get embarrassed because I'm like, I'm not going to be embarrassed. I was like, well, do you need to go to the car? Do you need to go to the bank? Like, what's tea? What you mean you forgot your wallet? I was like, well, can I get my bill, please? And he was like, oh, you're not going to pay? I was like, no, because I didn't, like, if you didn't have your wallet, why would you come and meet me? Now, mind you, I look at everything from a fat ass point of view, okay? Anybody who knows me, I'd be like, oh, you tried it because I'm fat. That's just me, okay? Maybe that's not the way it should be. Maybe that's not the case. But I got a fat ass point of view, okay? And that's just me. Everything I look at, I'd be like, see, if I was skinny, you wouldn't have tried it. But they probably still would have, because that's just something that people do. Okay, they try it no matter how you look. Whether you big or small, somebody try it, they gonna try it. It doesn't matter how you look, right? So, hey, boo. Hey. So, when we bring the check, girl, let me see y'all what happened. Now, y'all know we besties, so I'm just going to keep it 100. Tell me why I paid for my food Well, I tried to pay for my food and my card declined. So, I can't believe I'm telling y'all this. Girl, I had appetizers. I had ordered drinks. Girl, my card declined. Listen, y'all, wait. Listen. This one is called Fudge Me. Hey, boo. Hey, London. Hi, coffee. Hey. Girl, my card declined. But wait, let me just tell you what happened. Let me just tell you how good God is, y'all. Let me just tell y'all how good God is. Because my card declined. There was no reason for my card decline. The lady came back and wrote me a note. And she was like, basically what happened was, y'all know how they let you, it was my Capital One. And you know how they let you lock your card? Well, I had locked my card and forgot. And it completely just was off my mind. Because listen, I be having some of those automatic payments. And I don't be wanting to pay them automatic payments every month. And I don't need y'all to surprise me. Like, I need to know when my automatic payment gonna come out. I know it's only $5, but I need to know. And I be feeling like y'all be trying to get me. So I gotta block y'all. Instead of canceling it, because I still want to watch Hulu and Disney Plus, but sometimes y'all be doing too much. Sometimes it be my last $10, and here come Apple. And why I got to do 2 gigabytes of storage anyway? That's a scam. I'm sick of y'all shit. Okay? But anyway, that's not the point. So, I will block my card and then turn my card back on before I was ready to use it. But I forgot. It slipped my mind. It completely slipped my mind. So, I'm like, I'm embarrassed because I'm like, why is my card declining? But look how God, let me just show you how God did it, though. Guess who all of a sudden gets their wallet? Because I'm like, I was like, well, my card declined. He was like, what do you mean? How is it? What do you mean your card declined? Why would you come out to eat? He went off on me. Y'all, he went off on me. And I was like, all of a sudden, he's like, oh. Here. Okay, Daddy. I was like, oh, now you got some change? Now you got some money? So then I proceed, I'm like, we get back to the car. Then I think about it and I was like, oh, and so I was like, oh, you know what? I turned my card off. Let me turn my card back on. And I was like, by the way, I need to get some gas. So I'm like, I'm gonna go ahead and get some gas. I gotta stop right here. You know, oh, you think I'm a 44? That's so sweet. I'm actually an E, and I'm actually a 48, but thank you. That's very sweet. My titties must be sitting up. You was a hating asshole. Girl, I'm not new to this. I'm true to this. I've been doing this for a while. Good period of time, sis. I've been doing this for a while. But thank you. Ooh. But anyways, So, after we get through that, we get the gas or whatever. I get my gas. But I ain't gonna lie, I was being petty because I just need to prove that my car wasn't just declining because I was broke. Now, my car probably had not seen a full tank of gas for a long ass time. I don't know the last time. Uh-oh, did I block the wrong person? I apologize. I think I blocked the wrong person. If I blocked you by accident, I apologize. But Veronica, you got to go. You can't keep coming bringing your ass over here asking about my man. What if I didn't want the whole world to know I had a man? What if I was out here looking for my next ex? And you over here trying to tell my business? No, I'm not going to put no clothes on. Find you some business. Find something to do. Clean your house. Dog. Anyway. Okay, so. Then. He's come to me and he's like pull up to try to talk to me. And he's like, listen, you just gonna call it a night? Like, you ready to call it a night? I'm like, yes, I'm ready to call it a night. Like, I'm done. Good night. And he was like, well, it's really late. Now, mind you, it was like he just wanted to completely sidestep the fact that he just got finished lying, saying he didn't have no money at the restaurant. Like, Miss B, but he was lying, girl. He just got finished lying. Hey, kitten. Thank you for the roses, mama. He just got finished lying. Now, he's like, oh, well, I came a really long way. He's trying to talk me into coming to my house. And I'm like, no. I'm going to call it a night. He's like, oh, so you're going to, you know, you're just going to get me all the way out here just so you could play games. You're just playing games. You're not, you know, now I'm going to have to get a hotel. I'm like, sir, you only live a couple hours away from me. Like, calm down. Like, you cannot come to my house. Like, what is wrong with you? Like, I just met you. And he was like, you know what? You're just playing games all the way around. So he drives off, girl. He tells me good night. He drives off. So in my mind, I'm like, so mind you, we have been talking for like 3 months. And he was like, you know, let's delete our accounts or whatever. Well, I never deleted mine. But I just stopped talking people on there. Right? Thank you, E-Dub Green. Thank y'all for the gifts. Y'all are the best. I love y'all so much. So, tell me why he don't inbox me. I get home. I don't think nothing of it. He inboxed me and he's like, oh, see how you play games? I thought you deleted your account. Why would you have me coming all the way out there and you knew you didn't really want me? Why would you try that little trick on me at dinner? Wait a minute. You came all the way over here to see me in person. There was no pretenses. Second of all, you tried to play me because I was fat. And you thought we was going to go out to eat. And you was going to try to pull one over on me. Now, listen. I'm Jamaican. I don't go Dutch. That's not even in my culture. I don't go Dutch. If I can go Dutch, I can go with my girlfriend. Even when my girlfriends get together. Even when I go on girls' trips, my girlfriends don't let me pay. My friends don't let me pay. So why would I go on a date and pay for you and me? If you believe in going Dutch, that's you. God bless you. Be one with you. But if I'm going on a dinner date with a man, I'm not going to pay for myself, neither that person. That's not me. So I was not interested in that. So for me, it was just like, not only did you lie and try to get me to pay for your meal, but then you were completely okay with me paying for my own meal. And then when my card declined, you got mad at me and produced a card. So you're a habitual liar and a narcissist. I'm not interested. So I blocked him. Then he called me from another number, child. And start going off on me. And I really couldn't tell you what he said because I blocked him. Then we waited for a while. Like, I didn't talk to him. I kind of just chilled out. Like, I just was, you know. Y'all know me. You know, I was chilling. I'm a Sagittarius, so I'm not a relationship type of girl anyway. I like to have fun. So, I was just like, okay. So time goes by, girl. Tell me why this man didn't call me again. Talking about, I miss you. I made a mistake. I was hurting. My ex used me. My ex just used me. And I wasn't over my ex, even though I thought I was. Let's give it another chance. Like, sir, what are you talking? Like, this is the thing that confuses me. Like, what are you talking about? You told me didn't nobody want my big ass anyway. I forgot to tell y'all that. Before, like, when, not when he drove off, but when he got home and we was on, he got back on the website to find me, to cuss me out. Mind you, he could have just messaged me or FaceTimed me because I have not blocked him yet. What are you talking about? So you tried to pay for the food, but you didn't have the money. You're telling lies. Oh, my God. Y'all are slow. Like, what are you talking about? You are slow. Let me just be nice because I understand that sometimes people are slow. But that's irritating. This is NYX in the color Fudge Me. The moral of the story is, no, I don't rate myself. Let me make sure you understand, my love. I don't compete where I don't compare. I don't compete where I don't compare. I don't rate myself anything because I created my own lane. I don't compete with anyone. People who rate themselves compete. I don't compete. So why would I rate myself? Hello. I don't rate myself for anything. But obviously you do. Anyway, moving on. So, hey boo. I love it. I could tell when people know me. Hey boo. The moral of the story is, sometimes things will happen for your best benefit, right? If my card did not decline, I probably would have just paid for both meals just because I'm a nice person and I like to do nice things. So I most definitely probably would have paid. Let's just keep it real. I'm a nice person and I love to be kind to people. I don't like to be mean to people, right? That's just me. Listen, Sagittarius all day, every day. That's my point, Patti LaBelle. I got to see his true intentions because I really liked him. Let's be real. He was attractive, traditionally attractive, the traditional standard. Society would have accepted him and it would have been the real attractive guy with the real big bitch. You know, here's a big ass girl with a real cute guy. Y'all know how people do, right? So I was attracted to him. He was really sweet. There was no signs of him being a jerk that I could see. There was no signs that I could see. He was super nice. I'm a December Sag. Thanks, babe. I'm a December Sag. I did unlock my car after that. Did you not hear the part where I unlocked my car and went and got gas? Just to prove that I wasn't broke? But, I mean, what's the proof in that? Nope. He wasn't heavy. He was a handsome guy. Very handsome. Very, very handsome. Baby, listen, don't worry. Don't pay them no attention. Let me tell you, let me put you up on game, okay? People are insignificant, and they know that they're insignificant. They feel insignificant. So they come to a place where they feel like that person should be insignificant. And because they don't feel that way, they look for significance through other people. Case in point, they want to be the loudest one in the room. They want to say the funniest thing. Ha ha. Oh, they want to state the obvious. Oh, you're so fat. But bitch, so what's your excuse? What is your excuse? Like, I'm fat. So and what? And what else? Like what are you doing? Stop hating. Point of the matter is, I think hard that my card declined. Because it showed me who he really was. And it's so funny. Y'all be careful. It's a lot of people out here that's talking about they love big girls. But they be the first one to call you a fat bitch the moment that you don't do something that they want you to do. That's why I say be careful and diligent, because it's tax season. I'm just saying. LaWanda, thank you so much for the gift. Beautiful, I appreciate you. Listen, I can't, you know what I'm saying? Actually, I don't eat beef. I don't eat beef, honey. So a burger, I'm not a burger girl. Nice try. Okay, Ash. I'm looking forward to it. I miss you. I wish you were coming to Houston with us. I cannot wait. I'm so excited. Thank you. Thank you, boo. Oh, I do. These are from Pretty Little Thing. And I'm not attracted to men who pay attention to what women are doing anyway. That's a turnoff. I prefer men who do manly things. I've been working, Skippy. You know me. I love my work. I'm very passionate about my business. So I spend majority of my time working and making money. Where do you live, Leon's girl? Where are you from? You know, I travel all over the world. I might have already been to your city this year. I don't have to seek attention. You're watching me for free. Who's seeking attention? Thank you. Houston? Oh, I will be in Houston very soon. Oh, I want to go to Vegas. I think Vegas is on my calendar for next year. Can't wait to go to Vegas. Hello. For what? Why would I pay you? Oh yeah, Chicago's on my list also. Thank you, Chantel. Thank you for supporting me. I am new to TikTok. How long can I say I'm new to TikTok? Because I've actually been on TikTok for... Ashley, how long have I been on TikTok? Thank you for the gifts, boo. No, I don't really like to eat out. I don't mind having a cocktail, but I prefer like a private chef, or I like for things to be catered. Babe, you okay? What's the matter? Huh? You need me? Okay. Thank you. I don't rate myself. Cincinnati, Ohio. You know what? I don't know. I think I have a friend in Ohio. Thank you, Diego. Thank you so much. Okay, y'all, it's almost midnight. Listen, if you haven't already, now listen, don't go over to my YouTube channel with that foolishness. Because we don't play no games. Thank you, Nikki. Thank you. Oh, I love New York. I travel a lot because I love to travel. And my work, I travel a lot for my work and my business. Speaking of model, y'all, I gotta go. I have a campaign due tomorrow and I need to go to bed. Girl, there is no more water in this bottle. And I should not be drinking all this water this late. Look. You know what, Pink Roses? I am. You know me, right? And you know I love a basic black. Like a black one, two, one or two. That's it. But I have definitely been, I've been reaching out, branching out, doing something different. Oh, yes. Okay, y'all. Nope, I have not been to Indiana. I'm actually licensed in Indiana, but I've never been to Indiana. I love you guys to the moon and back. Ash, I'm looking forward to see you when you get back. I gotta go, you guys, because I want to go to bed. Yes, I do, Taeju. I'm just now getting over one. Of course. You know, Ashley, you know I got your back, girl. I love you so much. Listen, y'all, beauty is a state of mind, not body. Don't let nobody determine who you are, your value, your worth, based on how you look. Listen, if you don't want to be this the size you are, work on it. I'm working on my weight, but I absolutely love myself, and I refuse to discuss or, dignify people's bullshit. It's not necessary. You don't have to do that. You're worth so much more, and you're so much more deserving. Do your thing, you know what I'm saying? Do your own thing. You feel me? Do your own thing. Make your own way. Don't let nobody pull you down, and don't let them tell you about that confidence bullshit either, because that's backwards too. But anyway, listen, I love y'all. I'm out. I gotta go to work. Love you much, boo. Thank you, Lisa. That was very sweet of you. I'm out. No, babe, don't come out yet. Are you naked? Yeah, no, don't come out yet. I'm gotta cut it off first. Bye, y'all. Huh?